A year and a half ago, I had an idea. Wait, a year and a half? Has it really been that long? Jesus Christ, I hate how time goes forward at a steady and even pace unless acted upon by velocity and slash or gravity. Anyways, a year and a half ago, I had an idea. How hard could it be to do YouTube stuff? There are so many people that do it, after all, of all sorts of skill levels. Some people just plaster their face on a screen and talk about what's going on with them. Some make multimedia creations involving skilled writing, editing, and asset creation. So if all these people can do it, can I? Can I do it and then show how hard it is to do it? Well, a year and a half ago, I decided to give it a go. And then promptly gave up on the whole venture because it's all very scary. What if I went through a bunch of work and it just got deleted from the platform because YouTube is volatile and their systems are rife with abuse? Then I watched Endgame this year, and I had the motivation to do it. After 3 months of struggle, let's show what I've learned. This is the How Hard Could It Be to Make a Threecap, a 3-month recap of all I've done. Account creation is easy. You just need a Gmail account. Let's try taken. Maybe taken again? Well, apparently I hate myself for even trying with this nonsense, so let's try... not taken. Perfect. Okay, now it's just a matter of finalizing through all this nonsense, and now I have a new Gmail. Now we just go through all of YouTube's systems, add in a picture somewhere or another, and blammo, you have a YouTube channel. That's easy, though. Any data entry specialist can make an account. Ultimately, though, it's all about that dank content creation. It all begins with ideas, inspiration, the muses, cosmic entities of creation spiraling into one's mind and filling your brain with things to do, explore, and put out for other people to see, hear, and hopefully, ultimately, enjoy. This results in, at least for me, a script. Something to read, base all my ideas around, setting things up, often using it to plan what I'll put where in regards to footage or pictures. This is simultaneously easy and difficult. See, putting words to paper, or in this case typing them out, is one of the simplest things one can do. Presenting new ideas, viewpoints, and dredging creativity from a dead well of despair is, however, a task in and of itself. Clearing the cobwebs and oiling the gears of the creativity machine is difficult when your every attempt at it seems to result in pulling back even further into isolation. It's an ongoing thing, but I'm working through it. Okay, so after you make a script, you have to read it, right? There's a couple choices there. I could hire a voice actor with all that money I don't have, but unfortunately, I haven't spread my network that far yet. Or at all. I could use a text-to-speech program like that guy who makes videos reading Reddit posts, but then it just comes out dull, robotic, and I don't think it has a good singing voice. Obviously, that means recording my own stuff. With that comes a program I've had the audacity to use. Audacity. Actually, using Audacity has been a breeze for the most part. I record a lot of audio with the program. I've learned and adapted in cutting my recordings up like a professional butcher. Sure, I've also butchered the whole process a time or two, but that's part of the whole experience. The most important thing I learned, however, is noise reduction. I decided to start this whole thing during the height of summer in an area that is not comfortable during that time of year. If it were any more humid, I might as well be a fish. That means fans. That means a lot of noise in my audio. I also have a kind of crummy microphone, which means noise is still present even when I turn them all off. I don't have a recording studio, noise baffles, or any of that stuff, so I'd have to fix it all in post. Oh, the joy for me. There's another sound thing to talk about here as well. I gave some music creation a go, with LMMS, which resulted in a bit of a parody song. Hopefully there's more to come in that arena, but it takes time. A musical savant I am not. After that is gathering stuff to throw on screen. So let's talk about all the ways I've done that. I've sailed the high seas even though I own the movie I did so for it. I've uploaded, downloaded, and re-uploaded footage countless times through my PlayStation. I've recorded footage with OBS and then bounced it between computers through the cloud. I then had to use a program to change video file types just to make them work. I learned how to rip footage off of DVDs. I've created my own assets again and again and again, spending hours upon hours for almost every video I've worked on. Honestly, the only easy part of all this has been buying a capture card, and even using that had its own difficulties. What I've learned most is that the video part of making videos is a pain in the language. Neck. I was gonna say neck. Could somebody get that guy out of here? Jesus Christ, I was just gonna say neck. Now comes the process of slapping this whole mess together. Its own Pandora's can of worms. The process of throwing assets together is another simple yet complex problem. Learning new programs is difficult, but a lot of it is just drag and drop. Boop! There it is. After that, you get into the mess of audio and video editing within the program, chopping up your footage and recordings, finding just the right bit, learning how to do things like chroma keying. Chroma keying is when you take one color out of a picture and substitute something else into it. This is the process by which a lot of effects are done today. This makes me a computer-generated image amateur. I'd say professional, but I'm not getting paid yet. There's also easier things, such as learning to transition. Oh look, I overlap these two persons of video. I've created a transition. I'm a regular George Lucas. I can even add transition effects and make it look a little tacky or not tacky depending on the situation. See this? I can do this too. Zoop! There it goes. Bye-bye, old footage. I still have some stuff to learn in this sphere, and I really should see about trying more softwares with it, but oh well. Now, once you've done all this stuff and hit that render button, there's one more step. The upload. You just drag and drop that bad boy and then you have more stuff to do. Create and upload a thumbnail, set your tags, throw in a description, garble out some social media junk in there as well, add a title, and then go back to editing. These end cards don't make themselves after all. Unfortunately, due to my poor planning, I often don't have the end tags ready to go when I make the video, so it's a mad scramble to do it, or I just forget and then do it a day or two later. I'm getting better about that, though. Then I just share it wherever I can. I've made my own Twitter, a Facebook page, even tried Reddit. Unfortunately, every time I make an attempt on Reddit, I just get downvoted, removed, or ignored, so I'm just going to not bother with that anymore. It makes me the big sad. Most of the time, it's just person-to-person interactions. Discord, real life, stuff like that. So far, I'm almost halfway to my first goal of 100 subscribers. It's been really slow growing lately, so this goal will take a while. Viewership is also down, but I suppose that's to be expected. There are other difficulties, of course. I have a magical technological marvel at my fingertips at all times. Distractions are everywhere. Getting my own head into the tasks I'm trying to accomplish is taxing in its own ways. Cosmic paranoia, feelings of worthlessness, and self-doubt linger at the edges of everything I do. A busy schedule means constant interruptions, and overtime limits my ability to find time to do this whole thing. I've got this, though. I'm going to keep going, even if that means constantly asking for feedback, reassurance, and help. One step at a time. If you have an idea, send me an email, throw me a comment, or if you know me outside of this platform, well, I'm sure you know how to reach me. I'm always up for trying new things. After all, if I wasn't, I wouldn't be here, working on this project. If you thought this was interesting at all, make your own channel, record some audio, film something, edit together, render, release, and then go ahead and share it to my comment section. Anyone can do it.